Hi friends, and welcome to Crumbs from Gerard. The theme in today's Bible reflection is women, and the reading is from Luke chapter 8 verses 1 to 3. Jesus went on through cities and villages, and the 12 were with him, and also some women who had been healed of evil spirits and infirmities: Mary called Magdalene, from whom 7 demons had gone out, Jonna, the wife of Chuza, Herod's steward, and Susanna, and many others who provided for them out of their means. In Jewish society at the time of Jesus, women had a very, very low role. The only role of significance was in the house. Even education, we are told that women were hardly given any education, just the minimum. When it came to the synagogue, you needed a minimum of 10 to make up a quorum to have a synagogue service. But women were not counted in that 10. When it came to legal rights, from the point of inheritance, they had no inheritance. All that they got was maintenance. And divorce was left actually in practice only to the men who could divorce. Jesus came and changed all that. And Luke brings it out strongly. So for example, in Luke's gospel, we have women mentioned right from the beginning with prominence: Mary, Elizabeth, Anna, and the temple. Here we have also the place of women in the reading that we just had. Normally, a great rabbi would not have women as their disciples. In fact, rabbis wouldn't even want to teach women because they consider them inferior. What does Jesus have? First of all, he teaches women. And here we are told in the reading that he has them as disciples, and not only as disciples, he has them as traveling companions. And more than that, they have a significant role because they, out of their own means, provide and help for the maintenance and the journey of Jesus. In fact, in the Gospels we see that when Jesus died, it is women who are there at the cross. And at the resurrection, the first ones Jesus appears to is a woman. So women have a very special role. And that's what carries on in the church, because we have in Galatians where it is said, "There is neither Jew nor Greek, there is neither slave nor free, there is neither male nor female, for you are all one in Christ Jesus." So very clearly, for the church, women, men, there should not be any differences, though there could be, and you will see sometimes more often than it should. But now put on your thinking cap. In which area of your personal or public life do you need to have a more positive view towards women? How?